I'm Dave Gimberline, and I'd like to talk about a principle that I use in CUD application all the time, and that is that concept that the attacker might not be where you think he is. You have to, instead of being so linear in your thinking, you have to be open up to the idea that he could be anywhere around you. And this is very well demonstrated in some interpretations of Goju Shihosho. So in Goju Shiho, you are in a position, you turn to face this way, and shift your weight forward and back. Then you do one of these, and you step. And again, you shift and step. So your whole body weight creates places over and over again. Shifting in, shifting out. And I was told, when I first learned this kata, that I had an attacker who's doing a step and punch. You have to back up more. Doing a step and punch. And as he punches, I'm going to reach out here and grab him, and then I'm going to settle my weight back to pull him off balance, and then I'm going to knock his hand down, and this was a guard. This was doing nothing. It is conceivable if he was closer, you could be striking into the groin or hip joint with that hand, but the idea of reaching out to grab somebody that's punching 3 or 4 feet away from you is a little silly. So I have other applications. Come close. Where the person is here, and quite often they involve stabbing him in the throat, hooking his head, and throwing him on the ground. But none of those incorporate the turn. So to make this work, he's grabbed hold of you, and he gives you this to use. When he throws a punch, you pick your hands up to protect yourself, but you're going to use this hand that he gave you to turn. So I squeeze it into my body, turn my torso and shift my weight this way, that brings him forward. In a more formalized position, it's this way, right? So this is helping to trap his arm, and this pulls it in. This is up here in case his punch makes it to me. But when I turn, it pulls his hand away from me, and then I'm going to shift and drop him back with this hand. This would be releasing the hand from your gi. So you turn, slide back, and drop. This way, I guess. Grab with one hand. He throws a punch. You turn, shift your weight back, and drop. You can put this together with this sequence if you want to. He grabs with both hands. My defense is going to be to trap his dominant right hand, drive in and attack his face. That tilts the shoulders off to the side. I'm now going to pull down with this side and strike here, pull on this side, strike here, and here's the release where I drop them off to the side. One more this way. This traps his hand. This drives him backwards off balance. Switch, switch, release, and pull. It's actually theme that's repeated throughout the kata, including the very first move. Please like and subscribe my videos. Subscribe to my Kata for Self-Defense channel. It's also called Shoto-Ryu Goshinjutsu. Thank you. Good job.